First, if we examine the data sheet of the materials we are using, you will observe that there are pins available for timer 2. Therefore, you can use timer 2 when controlling PWM. Generally, timer 2 has up to channel 3. Here, we have channel 1, and then we have timer 2, channel 3, and next, we have timer 2, channel 1. For example, such as in this case, you can use timer 2. So, with the channels indicated on timer 2, you can control the PWM. This time I will be using timer 2 channel 3 to perform PWM control. First, just like last time, we need to import the library corresponding to PWM related timer 2. In the make file here, since we won't be using interrupts this time, please remove that part and then proceed with sm8tim2.c. Here you can see that sm8tim2 corresponds to the library for timer 2, which is essential for precise timing control in embedded applications. I have added tim2.c, a critical file that facilitates the operation of timer 2, and now I've moved to the main section where I carefully removed the interrupt to enhance system efficiency and added the sharp include directive for SM8's line 2 header to ensure all necessary components are included. Next, the LED port is not needed, and the macro details are not necessary here, and the interrupt function is also not required. Next, there is no need for GPIO settings, and here we will focus on the settings related to timer 2. If you wish, you can use all three channels, channel 1, channel 2, and channel 3 of timer 2 simultaneously. Instead of postponing the setup process, we will proceed with it immediately, right here and now. This involves configuring the system at the specified address, tim2.im2.l2.l2. By doing this, we ensure that everything is prepared and operational without any further delays. This sets up the PWM-related configurations, specifically the prescalaire for frequency settings. As you can see, the prescalaire can be set from 1 to 32768. Next, we set the period, which serves as the reference for setting the duty cycle. For this session, I will control the period conveniently with 1 byte, so it will be 256. Therefore, 255 corresponds to 100%. And if it is 128, the duty cycle will be 50%. This essentially sets the period based on the duty cycle, and since I mentioned basically controlling channel 3, you can use OC3. If you are using channel 2 or channel 1, you would use OC2 or OC1 respectively. You can use the same values here. The timer 2 state. Enable is now initialized with a duty cycle of 0. The polarity will obviously be set to high, and the duty cycle will be adjusted accordingly. After doing this, we will connect the LED, which will turn on and off. We will utilize the overflow. Since it's just 1 byte, when it overflows, it goes from 255 to 0 instead of 256. We will make it overflow by setting the clock in this function and then calling it from here. Here, for the duty cycle, corresponding to channel 3, you can change channel 1 and channel 2 to 1 and 2. But since it's channel 3 now, I will input the value and increase it. It's roughly 256. So, 256, 256, and since the period is 20 millimeters, that would be 5 seconds, right? It becomes completely bright and then suddenly dark, and you can do it this way. So now, if you look here, you set the Preskiller frequency, and then for the second parameter, you set the period. Channel 1, channel 2, and channel 3 are all set to the same frequency and the same period, but the duty cycle can be different for each. So, if you want to control up to 3 PWM signals, you can indeed essentially set the frequency and period to be exactly the same, while individually controlling the duty cycle to be different for each, in essence, precisely and specifically. Click. I didn't explain this last time, but if there are any changes in the Include section of the LIPS make file, please click Make once and then Run Make again. Now, it didn't fail. Right. Let's flash it as it is and check. The channel 3, specifically corresponding to timer 2, is PA3, and I have connected an LED to PA3, so it increases from 0 to 255, and when it reaches 256, it overflows back to 0, causing it to gradually brighten and then turn off and then brighten again and turn off, resulting in this effect, right? This is how PWM control can be implemented. In this session, I explained how to control PWM in SM8. I will return next time with different content.